ESPHome is a tool that allows to easily create custom firmware for ESP8266 and ESP32 ports. On today's video, I'm going to show you step by step how to use the ESPHome add-on in Home Assistant to flash a custom firmware to a Sonos basic switch. We're also going to look at some of the available components that you can customize via ESPHome, so you can integrate them and easily control them via Home Assistant. Alright, so to flash a firmware to a Sonos switch, you will need a couple of things. A USB to TTL converter, and also 4 male to female pin wires. You can find links for those items in the description below. Now, to be able to install the ESPHome add-on, you will first need to add the ESPHome repository. So open Home Assistant, go to Hassio, add-on store, and then under add new repository, add the following URL. Then scroll to the bottom of the list, click on ESPHome, and then click on install. If you have remote access set up for your Home Assistant using DuckDNS, you will need to enable SSL and also set up a port forwarding rule on your router for the ESPHome add-on. So scroll to the bottom and under config, change the SSL from false to true. Save the changes, then access your router settings and set up the port forwarding rule for the ESPHome add-on. Because all routers are different, I wouldn't be able to tell you exactly how to do this step. However, the configuration should be somewhat similar to this. After you have the port forwarding rule set up, go back to Home Assistant and start the ESPHome add-on. Give it a few seconds for it to load, and then click on Open Web UI. A login window comes up where you will need to sign in using the Home Assistant credentials to access the ESPHome dashboard. Now that the add-on is installed, you can start creating the configuration file for the Sonos switch. So click on the plus icon on the right to add a new node, enter a unique name for the device, make sure that the name is in lowercase and with no spaces. The characters allowed are letters, numbers, and instead of spaces, you can use underscore. Under device type, you can select the device that you are going to be flashing from the drop-down. The Sonoff Basic has an ESP8266 chip, so select generic ESP8266. Then enter your Wi-Fi credentials, and lastly click on submit. Okay, so the configuration for the Sonos switch is now created. However, it only has some basic settings. If you were to flash the firmware to the Sonos switch now, it would just connect to the Wi-Fi and nothing else. So you will need to edit the config file and add a few more components, like for example the switch settings to control the relay to turn the Sonos switch on and off. Let's go over some of the available settings that you can add. Click on edit to open the config file and enter the following at the bottom. The binary sensor would check for any time the button on the Sonos switch is pressed. The switch would trigger the relay on and off. The status LED is used to show the status of the device, letting us know of any warnings or errors. The Wi-Fi signal sensor monitors the received signal strength. The uptime sensor tracks the time in seconds the device has been online. The version tag sensor provides information of the current version of the ESPHome firmware installed on the device. Okay, so click on Save, and then click on Validate. This will check that the configuration is set up correctly. After it is validated, click on the More Options icon on the right, and then click on Compile. When the process is done, click on Download Binary. Alright, so you installed the ESPHome add-on, created the configuration file, compiled it, and downloaded it to the computer. Now, to flash the firmware to the Sonos switch, you can use the ESPHome flasher, which makes it super easy to flash the firmware from Windows or Mac. Now, open the case for the Sonos switch, and to be able to connect it to the computer, use the USB to TTL converter, and the 4 male to female jumper wires. Now, this is very important. Make sure that you don't have the Sonos switch connected to an electrical outlet. The only way the Sonos switch should be getting power is from the 3.3 volts coming from the USB converter. Okay, starting on the USB to TTL converter, connect the female ends of the wires to the ground, TX, RX, and 3.3 volts. Then connect the male ends of the wires to the Sonoff switch, but connect the TX wire to the RX pinhole and the RX wire to the TX pinhole. Now press and hold the onboard button on the Sonoff switch and connect the USB to TTL converter to the computer. Continue holding the onboard button for 3 to 5 seconds so the switch goes into programming mode. Launch the ESPHome flasher tool. On the serial port, you should now have the Sonoff switch coming up. Then for the firmware, search and select the binary file that you downloaded from ESPHome. Lastly, click on flash and give it a couple minutes for the process to complete. When the process finishes, restart the Sonoff switch by only unplugging and replugging the USB connection to the computer. If the switch connected to the Wi-Fi successfully, it would then show up online in the ESPHome dashboard. Now, to use the Sonoff switch with Home Assistant, you need to integrate it. So in Home Assistant, go into Configuration and then Integrations. At the top, you should have the new ESPHome device discovered. Click on Configure and then Submit. If the device was not discovered automatically, you can also manually add it. Look for the ESPHome integration and then click on Configure. Then enter the name of the node and then .local at the end. Or if you set up a static IP address for the Sonoff switch, you can also enter the assigned IP address for that device. Lastly, click on Submit and you should now have the Sonoff switch integrated. Click on it and the options that you set up under the ESPHome config file, it will now show up as available entities that you can use with Home Assistant. Alright, so the Sonoff switch has the ESPHome firmware installed and is integrated with Home Assistant. Now, if you want to make updates to the firmware, you can edit the config file in the ESPHome dashboard and do an OTA update. For example, let's make a change to the current firmware. Let's say we want the green LED on the Sonoff switch to either be on or off depending on the state of the relay. So if the switch is turned on, the LED would also be on and then off if the switch is turned off. Go to the ESPHome dashboard and open the Sonoff switch config file and replace the current switch and status LED with the following. Okay, so we set up an output that uses the GPIO13, which is the pin that the Sonoff switch uses for the LED. Then we added a light component linked to the output that controls GPIO13. Lastly, we set up two switches, a GPIO switch that uses GPIO12, which is the pin used for the relay. The other switch is a template that will turn on and off both the relay and the LED at the same time. Now for the binary sensor, under OnPress, you need to change the ID name for the switch that toggle from relay to relay and LED, which is the ID name that we set up for the template switch on this example. Click on Save and then Close. Now select Validate to check that the configuration is okay. Lastly, click on Upload to compile the firmware and upload it automatically to the Sonoff switch. Once the OTA update finishes, you could then turn the switch on and off, and the LED would also turn on and off depending on the state of the relay. The last thing that I want to show you today is how to open the ESPHome dashboard directly in Home Assistant instead of another tab. In your Home Assistant config folder, create a new file named panel-iframe.yaml. Then open the file and enter the following. This will create an option on the sidebar of Home Assistant named ESPHome. The URL is the Home Assistant local IP address, or if you set up remote access, then you will need to enter the DuckDNS URL plus the ESPHome port at the end. Save the file and then open the configuration.yaml file and enter the following. Save the file and then restart Home Assistant to apply the changes. When Home Assistant is back online, you will now have the ESPHome option on the sidebar. And when you click on it, it will open the ESPHome dashboard directly in Home Assistant. Alright guys, that's all I have for you today. What do you guys think about ESPHome? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I will see you in the next video.